Byla Alžběta Bátorijová skutečně vraždící bestie, po jejímž běsnění zůstalo až 650 mrtvých nevinných dívek? Až dosud jsem se setkával s jednoznačným názorem, že ano. O to víc mě překvapilo, když jsem se dostal na místo, které bývalo sídlem jedné z nejmocnějších rodin v Maďarsku.
Well, the Nádasdys were the one of the most important and most influential families around the early 16th century and the late 17th century. Ferenc Nádasdy was not very wealthy and he was educated and at the best universities around Europe, and he reached quite high positions in the royal court, and he managed to reach the Palatine position, that was basically the right-hand man for the king.
Jsme v Šárváru na severozápadě Maďarska. Právě na tento zámek se přivdala Alžběta Báthoryová.
Ferenc Nádasdy II, who was also known as the Black Knight, because he had very dark beard and also very dark hair, he played a very important part in fighting against the Turkish Empire when they invaded Hungary.
Nebýt obvinění z mučení a vražd, Alžbětu by nikdo neznal a do historie by vstoupil její manžel jako obávaný protivník Turků.
Yes, that's right. But they also respected him. Yes, they were scared of him because he attacked them all the time.
Jenže Alžběta Báthoryová svého manžela v proslulosti mnohokrát překonala.
Also in Hungary, I think everybody have heard about Elizabeth Báthory once, because they heard these rumors, these gossips about her, that she was like this lady Dracula and she bathed in virgin's blood and she was this horrible monster.
Moment povídačky. Zdá se, že tady v Šárváru se na krvavou hraběnku dívají dost jinak.
Unfortunately, as I mentioned, most people believe it about her. Maybe it's just the historians and those people that I mentioned that care to read about her and want to know her story better.
Možná je to tím, že Báthoryová byla Maďarka a taky tu vnímají poněkud smířlivěji. No, dejme tomu, že hodně smířlivě.
Yes, she was cruel. She wasn't very nice to her servants, but that wasn't a rare thing at that time. I mean, those servants who served in these lords' courts, they were from high position families, so even these lords wouldn't have done something so terrible to the servants, because their parents were very influential.
Dívat se na Alžbětu Báthoryovou jenom negativně nebo jenom pozitivně asi opravdu nejde. Nad lecčím, co se tady můžete dozvědět, se dá zamyslet a docela to i dává smysl.
I think it was fiction and most historians agree with this. She was a strong woman. Her husband died at a relatively young age and she inherited all their wealth. And she wasn't the very nicest woman in the earth. She was a little aggressive perhaps, but this trial that they made against her is most likely just to, because they wanted her wealth and she was a very beautiful woman, and many people were jealous of her.
Každopádně to vypadá, že na hraběnku, na kterou se dívá celý svět jako na nejhoršího zločince v sukni v historii, se tady nahlíží úplně jinak.
Unfortunately, still in the popular culture and still amongst just people in general, they think of her as this lady Dracula that I mentioned, and not many people care to read about her more carefully and to sort of try to face the facts It's easier to believe this fiction because it sounds very, very interesting and scary.
Jenže, když už tu jsou přesvědčeni o nevině Báthoryové tak silně, proč je v zámeckých expozicích nijak nepřipomínají? Proč to jediné, co tu Alžbětu Báthoryovou trochu připomíná, je původní podoba šachtického hradu? Jakoby tu přeci jenom někdo o svém přesvědčení pochyboval. Ale stejně, Šarvarský zámek je nádherné místo.
Yes, I would say that, and maybe it's one of the most well-preserved one. We were very fortunate in this respect because it was attacked by the Turks once, but they couldn't take the castle, and the world wars were very, so to say, generous to this castle because it was preserved extremely well.
Kdo tedy má pravdu? Šarvarští nebo zbytek světa? Možná se to třeba ještě někdy dozvíme.